Good morning, students. This is Nancy Sharma and this is your biology class. I am your biology tutor. So first of all, welcome to 9th class. I hope you all are well at your homes. So today we will discuss about the chapter cell. First of all, what is cell? We are doing the science subject. Science subject consists of mainly two types of sciences. One is physical sciences and another is life sciences. So cell is the entity which differentiates it from the physical sciences. Whenever you read about cell, you enter in a living world. Cell brings you to the living worlds. All other things are included in the physical sciences, that is physics, chemistry are part of physical sciences, and cell is a part of living study, life form, yani living life sciences. Okay, so cell is a basic unit of life. Cell actually introduce you to life. Okay, so in your previous classes you have read about two kinds of cells, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. So prokaryotic cells, pro means primitive and karyo means nucleus. So prokaryotic means the cells which have primitive type of nucleus, that is undefined nucleus, and eukaryotic cells have advanced nucleus, that is well-defined nucleus. Now what do we mean by undefined nucleus and well-defined nucleus? The nucleus which do not have any nuclear envelope is known as undefined nucleus, which is found in prokaryotic cell, and the nucleus which have well-developed nuclear envelope is known as well-defined nucleus, which is found in eukaryotic cell. Now, what is the function of cell? Why is there need of cell? Actually, all vital activities of life by which life continues, that is performed by cells. A function of cells, it performs all the life functions like intake of food, material, excretion, metabolism, respiration, irritability, etc. So next is history of cell. History of cells includes the contribution of many scientists. So in 1665, Robert Hooke discovered the cell. In 1674, Anton van Leeuwenhoek studied living cell for the first time. In 1831, Robert Brown, they discovered the nucleus and named that entity the nucleus. In 1838 to 1839, Schwann formulated the cell theory. Now, as you all know, living organisms are of two types. One is unicellular, another is multicellular. So, unicellular organisms include amoeba, paramecium, chlamydomonas, pseudomonas, and all rest are multicellular, like plant cells, animal cells, fungi, they all are multicellular. So there are some gadgets to study the cell. Gadgets means the instrument by which we can study the cell. Cells are too small to see by naked eye. They are studied with the help of microscope. So what are microscopes? Microscopes are high resolution instrument. High resolution means high magnification power. So these are high resolution instruments that are used for observing fine details of very small objects. There are two common types of microscopes. First is light microscopes or simple microscope. Another is electron microscope or complex, your compound microscope. So light microscope magnification range 100 to 1500. Electron microscope magnification range 1 lakh to 5 lakh. Another is different shapes of cell. The shape and size of cell vary, but all these cells ultimately determine the specific function. So you all are familiar with different types of cells. Here I draw some diagrams. So can you guess all these diagrams? This is amoeba, muscle cells, paramecium, euglena, RBC. Right? Some cells can change their shape. Amoeba can change their shape, no? But plants and animals have an almost fixed shape. So, smallest cell PPLO, that is mycoplasma cell. Largest cell, ostrich egg. Longest animal cell is nerve cell. Cell function, perform life activities like food materials intake, excretion, metabolism, respiration, etc. Cell possesses various organelles such as mitochondria, lysosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus. Each cell organelle perform different functions. Clearing waste material, protein synthesis and lipid synthesis. So clear karta hai waste material ko, protein ki synthesis hoti hai. Pehle DNA replication hoti hai, phir transcription hoti hai, phir protein ki synthesis hoti hai. Which you all will read in the higher classes. Lipid synthesis. Now we will discuss about the constituent of cell. Cell actually is made up of what? So cell is a tiny mass of protoplasm. Protoplasm is what? Protoplasm is cytoplasm plus nucleoplasm. So protoplasm, which is surrounded by membrane and is capable of performing all function of life. Protoplasm is surrounded by membrane. Which membrane? Plasma membrane. A typical cell is formed of three parts. So three main parts are there. Plasma membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. Sabse pehle plasma membrane hoti hai upar. Sabse innermost area nucleus and rest part is cytoplasm, which consists of all the organelles, cellular organelles possessing metabolic machinery. So what is function of plasma membrane? Membrane to create separate environment, to separate. So plasma membrane kya karti hai? So what is the function of plasma membrane? Plasma membrane separates cells from the external environment. Okay. Nucleus for its control. So nucleus is a brain of cell. Nucleus consists of genetic material. Nucleus consists of chromosomes. Cytoplasm possess metabolic machinery. Cytoplasm is a site of synthesis of protein. So we will discuss all these organelles one by one. First of all, we will discuss about the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is the outermost delicate elastic membranous covering of cell that separates its component from external environment is called plasma membrane, as we discussed all these information ahead. So what is the nature of this wall? This is selectively permeable. Selectively permeable, permeable, which permits the solvent, which permits the substance to allow through it. Selectively permeable means it permits selectively some substance, only certain substances. It is made up of lipid bilayer and proteins are integrated in its walls. Function of cell membrane, it provides cell shape to the cell. It acts as a mechanical barrier. It is a semi-permeable. Endocytosis and osmosis. Endocytosis and osmosis, all these functions we will discuss later in this chapter. So now we will discuss about the transport across the membrane. Membrane acts as a physical barrier between organelles and cells and cytoplasm. So there is some nature of membrane: impermeable, permeable, semi-permeable and selectively permeable. Impermeable. What do you mean by impermeability of the membrane? Impermeable, there are certain substances to which membrane is impermeable. That is, membrane do not allow those particles to pass through them. Permeable means membrane allows certain particles to pass through them. Semi-permeable is membranes allows solvent particles to pass through them. Selectively permeable means membrane allows solvent as well as certain solutes to pass through them. That is selectively permeable. So there are two types of transport of plasma membrane. One is active transport, another is passive transport. So what is active transport? Substance pass the membrane with consuming ATP. तो जिसमें ATP consume होता है transportation के time पे वो होती है active transport. ठीक है? एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट के ही अंदर आता है आपका बल्क ट्रांसपोर्ट. नाउ टर्म इज बल्क ट्रांसपोर्ट. बल्क मीन्स लार्ज अमाउंट. जब बहुत ज्यादा अमाउंट में हम सब्सटेंस को ट्रांसपोर्ट करते हैं वहां पे टर्म यूज होती है बल्क ट्रांसपोर्ट. लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस एंड पार्टिकल्स अक्रॉस द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. द प्रोसेस ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग द बल्क ऑफ मटेरियल्स फ्रॉम आउटसाइड बाय फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंडोसोम्स कॉल्ड एंडोसाइटोसिस. हियर द टर्म अगेन कम्स एंडोसाइटोसिस. आपने आप सबने अमीबा का केस देखा है. अमीबा में एंडोसाइटोसिस होती है ना. कैसे होता है? अमीबा के आउटसाइड फूड पार्टिकल होता है वो उसको एनगल्फ कर लेता है. स्यूडोपोडिया को राइज कर लेता है. कप शेप स्ट्रक्चर बनाता है और बाहर पार्टिकुलेट फूड को एनगल्फ कर लेता है. इसको हम एंडोसाइटोसिस कहते हैं. जब कोई मटेरियल हमने बाहर से एनगल्फ करके अंदर ले लिया सेल के, इस प्रोसेस को एंडोसाइटोसिस बोलते हैं. ठीक है. Another is exocytosis. Exocytosis is what? वही फूड पार्टिकल अमीबा के अंदर सारा प्रोसेस होके उसमें ही डाइजेशन होती है, अब्सॉर्प्शन होती है, असिमिलेशन. देन वही फूड पार्टिकल में जब वेस्ट बच जाता है तो अमीबा उसको अपने अंदर से रिमूव कर देता है. दैट प्रोसेस इज नोन एज एक्सोसाइटोसिस. देन अनदर इज पैसिव ट्रांसपोर्ट. पैसिव ट्रांसपोर्ट आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स. One is diffusion, another is osmosis. Both two processes are very, very important. First is diffusion. So diffusion is movement of substances from region of high concentration to region of low concentration. Movement of substances. Substances may be solid, liquid or gaseous form. From region of high concentration to low concentration. Let us illustrate it with an activity. Here is a beaker. Which consists of dye. So dye produces high concentration around this, okay, near this. Then it moves, solvent particle moves from a high concentrated region to the region of lower concentration. This is the diffusion actually. Then importance of diffusion. What is importance of diffusion? Diffusion helps in or aids in spread of different substances throughout the cytoplasm. It helps in exchange of respiratory gases between cells and environment. Transpiration is a diffusion process. Flowers spread aroma through diffusion and aid in pollination. और भी हमने डिफ्यूजन के एग्जांपल्स देखे हैं. जैसे हम डीओ को स्प्रे करते हैं या हम इंसेंस स्टिक को जगाते हैं, अगरबत्ती को जब हम इग्नाइट करते हैं तो उसका एरोमा आसपास में डिफ्यूज हो जाता है. सिमिलरली फ्लावर की स्मेल आपको कैसी आती है? थ्रू द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिफ्यूजन. एंड इट एड्स इन पॉलिनेशन. हाउ इट एड्स इन पॉलिनेशन? फ्लावर स्प्रेड इट्स एरोमा, इंटरैक्ट, इट अट्रैक्ट्स द इंसेक्ट्स. इंसेक्ट्स कम टू द फ्लावर एंड कलेक्ट द नेक्टर and thereby they perform the pollination. The next is the osmosis. Osmosis is defined as the diffusion of water or solvent across the semi-permeable membrane. Here the key term is semi-permeable membrane. The membrane which allows certain solute to move through it. Semi-permeable membrane from the region of its higher concentration to the region of its lower concentration. प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन फंक्शंस एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन. सो प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन का क्या नेचर होता है? कि वो सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन होती है. देन टाइप्स ऑफ ऑस्मोटिक सॉल्यूशन. देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ ऑस्मोटिक सॉल्यूशन. वन इज हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन, अनदर इज आइसोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन, अनदर इज हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. सो व्हाट इज हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन? Hypotonic solution in which concentration of solute is less and concentration of solvent is more. First of all, try to understand what is solute and solvent. The substance which is in less quantity is solute and substance which is in more quantity is solvent, like sugar solution. In sugar solution, sugar is in less quantity, so sugar is solute, and water is in high quantity, large quantity, so water is solvent. So hypertonic solution is where solute is in less concentration and solvent is in high concentration. Isotonic solution in which both solute and solvent are in equal concentration. Hypertonic solution in which solute is in large concentrate large amount and solvent is in less amount. Okay, so these are three types of osmotic solutions. Now types of osmosis. One is endosmosis, another is exosmosis. Endosmosis is the entry of water molecules into the cells through semipermeable plasma membrane when surrounded by hypotonic solution. Exosmosis is, it is the exit of water molecules from the cells through semipermeable plasma membrane when surrounded by hypertonic solution. Now, what is cell wall? Cell wall is rigid, semi-elastic, semi-transparent and protective covering outside the plasma membrane in plant cell. In plant cells, fungi and prokaryotes. So, cell wall is made up of cellulose, as you all know, in the plants, fungal cellulose and chitin in fungi. Extra deposition of lignin, suberin, cutin may be present during the secondary thickening. Sometimes, in addition to cellulose, there is a thickening of lignin, suberin and cutin to reduce the transpiration rate. Cell wall possess small pores through which adjacent cells remain in contact called plasma desmata. So, plasma desmata are the structure in which pores are there to make the connection, in order to make the connections between the adjacent cells. And now, there is role of cell wall. What is the role of cell wall? It provides shape to cell. It provides mechanical strength to cell. It provides protection from pathogen and external or physical barriers. Next is, it prevents bursting of cells on endosmosis. Next, it provides ability to withstand lot of variation in the nature. Now, there is slight differences between the cell wall and plasma membrane. What are these differences? This is cell wall. Minor differences you all have read in the previous classes, that it is present in plant cell, it is present in animal cell. Another from these differences are, cell wall is rigid and thick, whereas plasma membrane is flexible and thin. Cell wall is permeable, plasma membrane is selectively permeable. Cell wall is formed of cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin, whereas plasma membrane is made up of lipids, proteins and small number of carbohydrates. Cell wall provide protection and strength to cell. Plasma membrane hold cellular contents and control passage of materials. So that's all about the today's session. In next session we will do the rest part of the chapter.